Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you how to get the date for the next Monday after any given date in Microsoft Excel. So by the end of this video, you should be able to put a date in A2 and then calculate the date of the next Monday right here in B2.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So if I put a date in A2, let's just say today's date, 8:30, and then I go over into B2 and I type equals workday.intl and a left parenthesis. The first thing I'm going to be prompted for is my start date. So what date am I starting with where I want to calculate the next Monday? So I'm just going to click on the date I have right here in A2 and then type a comma. And now my next argument is days. So this is not really a number of days or a day of the week. We're going to get into that in a minute. But the number we want here is how many Mondays. So I can either go forward to get the next Monday or backwards to get the previous Monday. Or I can go 2 Mondays from now or 3 Mondays from now. So if I put a -1 here, I'm going to get last Monday. If I put a -2, I'm going to get 2 Mondays ago. If I put a 2, I'm going to get 2 Mondays from now. But in this case, I'm going to put a 1 because I want to know the Monday that is coming right after 8:30. And then I'm going to type a comma. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. And now this next string is a little complicated, so I'm going to explain it right now. In double quotes, I'm going to put 7 digits, and each of these digits is going to represent the day that I would like. So I'm either going to put a 1 or a 0 7 times, just like 7 days a week, and I'm going to start with Monday. So if I put a 0 here for Monday, and I put a 1 for Tuesday, 1 for Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, close my quotes, close my parentheses, and hit enter. I can see that 9/2 is now being calculated as the next Monday, which is correct because that is the next Monday after 8:30. So if I click in B2, how would I get the next Tuesday? Well, I'm just going to click in here in my string of ones and zeros. And instead of having 0/1 here, let's backspace and put 1/0 and hit enter. And now I can see that I'm being returned with 9/3, which in fact is the next Tuesday after the date that I have right here. So depending on how you configure these ones and zeros, you will get the next whatever day you're looking for from this date right here. Just make sure you have a 0 in the position of the day that you wish to return. And also keep in mind, you can put a 0 in multiple places and return the next Tuesday or Thursday, or Wednesday or Friday. Now, if this seems a little confusing to you, we go into this a lot more in detail out on our blog, and I'm going to include a link to that blog entry in the description below on YouTube if you would like to go there and learn more. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.